Hello everyone. Today we are doing a session of all the bodyweight exercise. This can be done for the professional athletes and also for normal general fitness as well. So all you need is your entire body and some space to do this exercise. So today we are doing a session with the professional athletes, as you can see. We're going to start with the high knee exercise. This is a functional exercise at the same time. It is going to help you increase your speed, your endurance, and at the same time, strength. So this combination is going to increase your explosive strength in your body. So we're going to start with the high knee exercise with our professional athletes. So as you can see, there is proper combination of upper body and your legs. Your arm movement and your leg movement is same at the end. And you have to make sure that the combination is correct. And you enjoy the exercise at the same time. So now we are going to do our second exercise. But there is an important thing that you take only 30 second rest. That is for your recovery of the muscles and your body. So now we are going to do our second exercise, but there is an important thing that you take only 30 second rest, that is for your recovery of the muscles and your body. So second exercise that we are doing is squat jump. In this, we are going to do it along with a vertical jump, and at the same time we have to move forward. So this is again going to help you build your explosive strength in your upper body and basically the muscles that are below your waist. So as you can see, we are going to use our glutes, the hamstrings, your quads, and mostly the lower body strength is built up in this exercise. So as you can see in this, you're going down at least at a 45 degree angle and you're taking a vertical jump. Third exercise that you're doing is a combination of your upper body strength and your lower body strength. It's a combination exercise that is going to definitely increase the explosive strength in your upper body, at the same time your lower body as well. So this is jump push-up that we are doing. As you can see, we are going to start. So in this, if you see, they are taking a jump in the push-up. So this is going to help to increase the explosive strength. So fourth exercise that you have to do after a break of 30 seconds is a skip with 3 taps. So in this exercise, all you have to do is you have to keep your angle up, keep your knee up at 90 degree angle. And this is basically exercise that is going to improve your ankle strength and it is going to build your agility and speed. So all those games, you know, where you need a lot of sprinting like football, basketball, this is something that is really very helpful. So let us see how to do this exercise effectively. It's a very good combination exercise for the upper body and the lower body. And this exercise is also going to improve your explosive strength. So all these exercises that we are doing today, they are all, you know, mainly your body weight exercise. So our fifth body weight exercise that we are doing is burpee jump. In this, it is again an explosive exercise. In this, you are going to use your upper body and your lower body. So in this exercise, you have to take a jump and then you have to do a push-up. So let us see how we are doing this exercise. So this is going to improve your vertical jump, and in this exercise you need to have really good upper body strength. So this exercise basically you're doing in a very short span of time and you're exerting your muscles at the same time, which is going to help you build endurance and speed in your body. The sixth exercise as part of the routine that we are doing is box jumping on the box. So we are going to do different variations on the jumps. So this is basically an exercise that builds the frequency in your body, which is really important in all the sports that involves sprinting exercise, you know, sprinting, that games like football, then you need hockey, and especially the 100 meter. So as you can see, we're going to do the jumps on the box. So this is definitely going to increase frequency in this exercise. You have to make sure that your core is stable and it is going to use your abdominal muscles and it is going to build your glutes at the same time. As you can see, it's going to build your entire lower body strength, all the exercise, all the muscles. So the seventh exercise that we are doing is a variation of the sixth exercise that we are doing, like jumping exercise. So we'll just start. It's going to utilize all the same muscles that we mentioned earlier. So the eighth exercise that we are doing is again a full body exercise. In this, what we are going to do is we are going to keep your upper body stable and there is movement in the lower body. So this is going to build strength in the upper body and it's going to increase the flexibility in your lower body as well, and it is going to increase strength in your abdomen. So this is a variation of the ninth exercise is again a full body exercise, a variation of the mountain climbers that we just did now. But in this exercise, what we are going to focus is we are going to utilize our legs. So we are going to increase the stride length. So when there is more flexibility in your trunk, it definitely impacts the stride length in your body. So let us see how to do this. In this exercise, we keep our upper body stable, again building strength in the shoulders, and we have to do the movement with your legs. Again, you see there is good amount of improvement in the stride length that we are doing. So this is our 10th exercise that we are doing for the upper body strength, which is shoulder dips. So mostly in the session that we are doing today, there are people can have 8 to 12 exercise. It depends upon the level of the player that is doing, whether they are amateur, they're intermediate or they're professional. So in this session, you can see we are doing the 10th exercise with this shoulder dip, and it is going to increase the strength in your upper body. So now we are doing our 11th exercise. This exercise is going to focus on your agility, and agility, when you are doing an agility exercise, it is going to help you increase your speed in the body. So this is a different variation that we are doing with the footwork. Let us see how to do this exercise. Now we are doing our 12th exercise. So this is again a different variation of the footwork. It is again going to focus on your agility. And when you're doing agility exercise, as we said, it is going to improve your speed. And when you have speed, it is going to definitely help you improve your performance in all your sports. So let us see how to basically do this exercise. Completely focus on your footwork. So after we have completed our session, it is very important that we need to cool down the body. Cooling down is important because you are going to prepare your body for the next day, and it is going to make sure that the body temperature comes down. And the body temperature comes down, there are very less chances of injury that you are left with. So you have to make sure whenever you do any type of workout, you need to make sure that you are doing particular kind of cool down as well, the muscles that you have used. So you are going to cool down all this exercise. And as you can see, there are multiple different things that you do in a cool down. You are basically calming down, you are relaxing down your body. The lactic acid that is built up during the workout, it has to be released from the body. And this is part of the workout that you are going to do the next day, that you completely relax your body and you you know, release the stress and the tension that is built up in your body, and your mind also cools down in this. And it also releases happy hormones when you are doing it along with the group that you know you have completed the workout. It releases a positive energy, and you prepare your body for the next day. And make sure that you include it in every workout that you do. That cool down has to be there in each and every workout. And after we have completed with the, you know, running cool down, now we are going to do the cool down with the flexibility and basically on ground stretching, on floor stretching that we are going to do. So this is like, you know, we are going to show you in the next workout how to do a proper cool down on ground. So stay tuned for our next workouts. Thank you so much.